So this crumpled up piece of paper is a list of all the multiple choice tips, secrets, points that I shared with one of my private students. And I'm about to share it with you. Alright, back to the multiple choice tips. One, do all multiple choice questions that you get your hands on. All multiple choice papers that you get your hands on. Let me say something. CSEC multiple choice papers, I wouldn't be doing any on the channel, the past papers that is, because of the copyright. You probably already realized searching on Google for past papers in paper one is a kind of hard thing because CSEC clamps down on the multiple choice questions. They don't want you publishing, especially very recent multiple choice questions. Personally, I think the main reason for that is because there's a big well of questions that they choose from, and a lot of questions repeat year after year. And by a lot of questions, I mean a lot of questions repeat. So looking past that, you want to do as many practice multiple choice questions as you can get your hands on, because there are only a limited number of themes they can create questions on. So as you begin to do a lot of multiple choice past paper questions, you'll begin to see ideas repeating. A lot of the ideas just repeat over and over and over and over and over. Number two, write working in order. Well, this was just for this one particular student. The working no one sees that. They just see what you shade. But for your own purposes, you should write your working in a way that if you have to go back and check, you could see everything. Number three, watch answers first. So these points are not listed in any order of importance, but this point is really important. Watch the answers first. For a huge chunk of the questions, you can actually get the correct answer by eliminating the three incorrect answers, because you know it's just four answers, A, B, C, D. So even if you just guess between A, B, C, D, you should get it correct one out of four times. So you should just watch the answers and eliminate the ones that don't make sense before you begin to, you know, do the question. Number four, there's no calculator in this exam. You need to sharpen up on your multiplication, division, your arithmetic. You need to be able to divide big numbers. You need to be able to multiply big numbers. Number five, sets is in this. Vectors and matrices is in this. This is an updated version of your multiple choice. Number six, I told the student to remember that the answer is in front of you. Sometimes you can forget that the answer is right in front of you. One of these four things is the correct answer. So practice elimination. Number seven, leave out nothing. You don't lose marks if you put a wrong answer. So answer every single question. Even if you have to guess some, answer them. Number eight, learn all your formulae. By the way, I think in one of the last videos I said formulas instead of formulae, but I am a maths teacher, not an English teacher, so... Number nine, don't shade two things. Don't double answer. I don't know why people are doing this. If you double answer, listen, most likely it's a computer going to correct your paper. If the computer see two answers, it will either pick the darker answer or cancel that whole question. So double answering ain't making sense. Just shade one and move along. In number 10, I reminded the student that there's a limit to how many ways they can ask stuff. There's a limit. There's a limit to the different styles of questions that they bring. And with CSEC, the limit is very small. As I said, things just repeat. Ideas repeat. Concepts repeat. Sometimes the entire question word for word. A lot of times, actually. Number 11, if you're unsure about a question or you're taking up too much time, just put a star on it and we'll come back to that question. Time. The exam is 90 minutes. You have 60 questions. You know what you have to do? 1.5 minutes per question. But some people think that means to spend 1.5 minutes on every question. No. Some questions are designed to be longer in time, and some questions are designed to just be at 10 seconds and you figure out the answer. Sometimes you just watch it. I know the answer. Shit. But some questions might take you 5 minutes. One or two questions might take you 3 minutes, 4 minutes, 5 minutes. So you need to think of it as a race, a very careful race. Number 13, when you feel you got the correct answer, but you check the working and boom, it's not there. Look through the working and see and check for clues and pick the best answer. Sometimes maybe round off stuff. Watch the question, maybe you forgot out something. Number 15, for that student, when they were feeling unsure and they got two answers that could either be correct. They eliminated two, but they got two that could be correct, and this happens a lot of times. I told him to go with the answer that they thought was correct first all the time. We just picked that method because it seems that that method works best for him. Most of the time, the one that he thought of first was correct was actually it. So by and large, these strategies could apply to nearly any subject area. So you have to know how you're going about your multiple choice.